Year 2012. I was in my teens. My college, being in Bandra, was usually surrounded by superbikes, but none impressed me as much as the Kawasaki Ninja 650. And here began my journey. For a middle class guy like me, owning such a bike means shelling out a fortune. And yeah, the family pressure of why not a car? Even though under the pressure, I approached the dealership. A completely different type of an experience altogether. You feel special as soon as you step inside and see so many super bikes around you. 20th March 2019, when I finally accomplished my dream. Just like humans, no bike is 100% perfect. As soon as I returned to my colony from the showroom, I had to face these. And that's how my baby got its first belly scrape.
Now, since this is just an ownership experience, I shall not get into the technicalities. Let's just focus on what I like and what I do not like about the motorcycle.
So let's talk about what I do not like about this motorcycle.
The first one has to be the ground clearance. At just 130 mm, I get a mini heart attack if I see the smallest of the speed breakers, let alone the famous Indian potholes. At times, you get a rush to open the throttle and disappear. Well, careful on this one. Since there is no traction control to save your back, the tail spins at the slightest of extra twist. If you are an experienced rider, then you wouldn't face any such issue. Now have a look at these turn indicators. Yeah, these are the stock ones, but you see these rubbery particles. The stock ones tend to break on their own. It costs about 3500 for a single indicator, but you know, due to the lockdown, I couldn't get it even after waiting for a long time, so I just had to do a bit of desi jugad. Okay, now this isn't actually a con, but parking this bike is a real struggle at times.
Sunna isko kiche ya. ये प्रीतेश प्रीतेश ये डुएट है ना डुएट डुएट को उधर चिपका है ना हाँ
नॉट बिकॉज इट इज हैवी और एनीथिंग बट जस्ट बिकॉज इट इज एन अटेंशन सीकर
यहाँ पे नहीं लगाना बुकिंग है अंदर अंदर बुकिंग है
बुकिंग है तो सब तो बुकिंग है तो उधर गाड़ी लेके गाड़ी थोड़ा नियम है
मतलब
बुकिंग है ना
हाँ हाँ
यहाँ तो कम होटल का पार्किंग है ना ये तो गाड़ी यहाँ रुका था तो आपने दो आज आई थी दो गाड़ी आई थी इधर रुका ही थी उधर जगह ही नहीं ना अरे वापस आने से पहले हमारे पे भरोसा था कोई इधर लगा दो गाड़ी
Honestly, I'm afraid to leave it without supervision even for a minute.
Talking about attention, now let's begin with what I love about this motorcycle. I'm not even sure where to begin with. It's a complete package and a really value for money motorcycle.
It is indeed a beautiful looking machine. You stop at a signal or just cruise on a highway, like you will definitely see at least a couple of heads turning towards you.
Oh, did I talk about speed?
Well, you'll touch the Indian legal speed limit on the first gear itself. Go on the second gear and you'll cross 100.
Okay, you guys must really listen to this exhaust note. It's a very, very, very nice one. Okay, I knew you fell for it, but trust me, you'll never get that superbike sound. But this growl though. Yeah, I'm literally fine with it.
The bike handles really well. You feel like you're sitting in the bike and not on the bike. In terms of protection, I've just added these frame sliders and the radiator guard by RNG. and I've just got a ceramic coating done.
To sum up, the service intervals are at 6,000 kilometers or 6 months, whichever is earlier. And every servicing actually costs about 5,000 to 6,000 rupees. But yeah, if you like to get your hands dirty and you can do a quick fixes like changing the oil filter, then the air filter, brake pads, kind of these things, it will save you a hell lot of money. So who should buy a Ninja 650? And is Ninja 650 a good beginner bike? It is a fairly easy to ride motorcycle, but then Indian road conditions does not make it for a good beginner bike. It's got a lot of power to offer, so I would recommend you start on a smaller displacement bike and then jump to this middleweight bike. Okay, when should you upgrade to a super bike? Well, the answer is really subjective. Some people directly hop onto a 1000cc bike, whereas some people start on a smaller displacement and then kind of gradually upgrade to a bigger displacement bike. I literally started on a 125cc motorcycle, and in the beginning I thought, okay, that's all I need. But then, you know, the hunger of power and all. And right now there is a difference of literally 56 horses. A few tips before buying a superbike. Firstly, make sure you have a lot of savings. Only then you should even think about buying a superbike. It's really expensive to maintain. Build your riding skills. Don't be a squid. Ensure that you're riding with all the safety gears. And yeah, try to learn a little bit of maintenance. It will help you save a lot of money.
Okay, so not wasting any further time, I'll just conclude by answering the most important question every Indian has to ask.
Kitna deti hai?
So I get a mileage of about 20 to 21 under mixed riding conditions and about 22 when on speedways.
One good thing about this bike is you do not need that high octane power petrol. So normal petrol is fine enough.
Hehehe